guys, here it is, Salifish S8 by Cuzzy Bros Fishing. We'll give you a bit of a walk around. As you can see, it just fits in the shed, so bonus there. We'll start seeing as how we're down here and up the front. So we've gone for the recessed lights, LED light bars, one on each side. They work relatively well. I thought they'd be a little bit brighter than what they are, but that they do the job. We've used them a few times now out snapper fishing, and they light up enough area where they're usable. I'd probably recommend going something a bit more brighter or a bit bigger wattage in those ones if I was going to do it again. Gone the Lone Star winch. That's a feature on all Salifish boats. So I had a different brand winch on the last boat. This winch seems to be really good though. I can't fault it to date, so really happy with the Lone Star winch. On the front here, we've added the boat catch. Had it on the last boat, have to have it on a boat these days. It makes launching and retrieving a boat so much easier, especially if you're gonna do it by yourself. So even a boat of this size, I've had no problems so far launching this and retrieving it by myself, so really happy with the boat catch. Also added the ladder on the front here for getting up and down to clean the boat. It just makes life a little bit easier climbing up and down. And we've also added the stone guards. Stone guards, once again, are a must on a boat these days, or on a trailer boat if you want to protect that paintwork. So it goes without saying that you need to put those on. Took it to Burge's Signs here in Seymour. Burge did an awesome job with the sign writing as always. So just one more, and the Rego stickers and everything are all done in the Australian flag. Obviously the boat's Australian made, so we're going with the Australian theme here. Paint job's awesome. Salifish do an excellent job on their paint job and the finish of their boats. So that was part of the reason why we went with the Salifish, or not just part of, but a little bit of the reason. Also added the Relax riggers. Had Relax on the last boat. Once again, sticking with that brand, they've been excellent. Their after sales support is second to none. Not that I've had to really deal with it, but on the one or two times that I did deal with it, they were excellent. So once again, we've stuck with those guys. Those riggers are a lot easier than the last boat as well. They just drop down and fold back up, so it makes life a little bit easier. Moving down towards the back here, we've gone 2 1-kilowatt transducers through hull, and they're mounted just in there on the boat. A high chirp and a low chirp running through a BSM-3. So far to date, they've been excellent. Business end, Honda 135 four strokes. First time I've ever owned Honda engines. And to date, I'm really impressed with them actually. The fuel economy that we're getting out of these things is unbelievable. So 2.1 liters per engine at 11 kilometers an hour. So we're burning 4.2 liters out of both engines combined for our trawling speed at 11 Ks. And you know, they're quiet. Once they get going, they sound phenomenal. Like they sound like they're supercharged actually. They've got a really good note to them. So really happy with the Hondas. We've had them serviced, so they had their first service today, which was their 20-hour service. We've actually put 25 hours on the boat already in 2 weeks, so we're well underway. But like I said, the Hondas to date, really impressed. So yeah, not really much more to say there. I only went the 135s on the recommendation from the guys at Salifish. I could have put 150s on it, but the boat gets along at 80 kilometers an hour as it is, so pretty happy with the top end speed. Moving around the back, so getting up into the boat at the back here. So this is the walkthrough between the two engines. You step up, the finish on the floor is phenomenal. So this is a Salifish finish. And the workmanship that they've put into this is excellent. So starting down the back of the boat here, live bait tank, all plumbed. It's got a blue light and everything in there, so you can see the fish of a night when you doing that sort of fishing. Nice big tank. You can see that they've gone with the aluminium tube across here and just drilled holes into it, and that you don't have that screw in or that bung in a lot of the boats these days, and that has been really well finished. I also think it allows a lot more water to get through and get into the live bait tank, which aerates your slimies and all that stuff a lot better. So longevity of those guys is really good. Each engine's got its own C-Star steering hydraulics. So a lot of the cats don't do that. They run a rod between the two engines, but Sailfish have put in two, on one on each side. So that's another feature there. The bait board, is really well finished. So everything that you need is here, bar your knife rack. I've spoken to Sailfish about it. I've added that knife rack and everything to the actual chopping board itself, but for a chopping station or a working station of this standard, that is the only thing that it's missing. And you can't fault this workstation at all. The slimy tubes, unbelievably finished. You know, you can fit tuna in there as well, if need be, or if you're gonna run big skip baits, which we're planning on doing. So this is a standard fit out from Sailfish. I haven't gone and asked for anything extra. This is just what comes out of their factory as a standard. So once again, Sailfish on point and finishing the boat phenomenally. I've got a wash down put in here. That's a salt water wash down. I've also got a fresh water one up the front over there. So salt water down the working end just for cleaning your chopping boards and anything else in the back deck after you get blood on it and things like that. This stuff here is all salt water run as well, so you can hose down. This moves left and right, up and down, and you can obviously dictate how much water and everything else you want to put in there, or how quick the water flows. So it's all really well finished. Just picks up, move it to wherever you want, and then drop it back down. So really well done there. The electronics in the boat, the finish, like I said, is phenomenal. So as you can see here, this is where the main hub or power output for all the electronics is. Really neat, really tidy, really clean, and just looks the part, as well as practicality. It's easy to access when you want to turn everything on and off or isolate something. So not an issue there. Over this side, just got a locker storage for tackle and things like that. I've set it up with squid jigs and, you know, just a few odds and ends that you normally wouldn't use when you're game fishing, but you might want if you come across certain things. So they're just set up in there and easy for access. Once again, Sailfish, you know, they like to keep things symmetrical. So the way they've set it up down the back is exactly the same on port and starboard side. Inside here is the batteries and all your fuel pump, all that sort of stuff. So really good. This side, on the starboard side, has only got the one battery in it. So we're running starter battery for each engine, and then a house battery for the electronics and everything else. So really well fitted there. This here just opens up so that you can get into the water pumps and access that, and then that's the same again on the other side of the boat. Okay, we had these rod holders down here, custom made. I've got one for each side of the boat. The finish on those is phenomenal, and they're really practical. They're also set up so that with your game rods, the butt of your rod slides into, like it is into the gimbal, so it can't turn. So when you're running home and things like that, they're not banging against the side of the boat or anything like that. They're fixed in there and you can't move them. Also gone ahead and put a barbecue on the boat. So a little gas barbie, it bolts straight on here, just lifts in, lifts out. And that has been excellent as well. We've used that over New Year's Eve and a couple other times now, And you can't beat fresh fish. I mean, literally catch it, fillet it on the table down the back there, and then put it straight on the barbecue, and you can't go wrong. This is where we've fitted our freshwater deck wash. I wanted it put up here so that when we're coming home from out on the shelf or wherever we're fishing, the guys out on the back can be cleaning down all the rods, and we can store them out of the salt spray and they're clean. That way when we get in, there's less work to do cleaning other things and things like that. The filler cap for that, for the deck wash, is just up there on the side. It's easy to access and it's far enough away so when you fill up at the fuel tank, you're not going to think that that's a fuel fill point. So if someone else is filling the boat, they shouldn't get confused with that. I've also added these rod holders in the back here. These rod holders are for the bent butt rods, just so that they're in here out of cover and they're also out of the way. I'm still not sold on them, to be honest. Everyone who sits in that seat hates them, so you just can't sort of lean back. But they do allow me to get the rods, those bent butt rods, out of the way. So it's a bit of give and take, I suppose, and we'll see how we go with that with our next post in the future. Okay, moving over to the starboard side. I had these gaff tubes added to the boat. These are an extra. They come up really, really well. There's a couple of little things that probably need tweaking. Once you get that rod holder, that rod holder there, over on this side, you can't access the bottom gaffs. So there's practicality is a little bit of an issue. So I'm just sort of trying to work a solution around those at this stage. But the fit out and the way they're done is excellent. So I've got my two tag poles and my gaffs from Hook'em all in here ready to go. So it's easy to access. Under seat storage, this one here is all the cleaning gear. Everyone that knows me knows I'm pretty fanatical about having everything clean and ready to go. So that's all kept in there so when we pull in or even on the way home, boys can be washing down the deck and getting everything cleaned and all that sort of stuff. Over this side, this is a massive locker, this one. Normally from Salifish, they come with a slide on it for a fridge or a freezer. I didn't want the fridge slide. We've got an Esky that just goes in and out of there, a 47 litre Esky, Evercool Esky, and it fits perfectly. So it was just something else that we didn't decide to do, but you know, it comes standard. We ended up taking or getting rid of that. The other thing that I've done that Salifish don't do as a regular is I've dropped the rocket launchers down so that they're near flush mount with the roof. I did that for a couple of reasons. Obviously, first one, I'm vertically challenged, so I need to be able to get those rods out, and they're too high when they're all the way up. The second one is getting it into the shed. As it is now, I've got a centimeter's clearance between that middle launcher, so I needed to drop them down to get the height clearance for getting it into the shed. Another standard on Salifish is the panel out the back here, so that anyone out the back who's dirty and covered in fish guts and all that sort of stuff doesn't have to be going in and out of the cab. They can operate everything out the back here. I've also gone and added a Fusion remote so that when we're out the back, we can turn the music up, turn the music down, change songs, all that sort of stuff without having to go into the cab. Got two solid glass doors here that are lockable, and that was one of the big selling points on this boat for us, is the lockable cab. Because of the traveling that we do and how we fish, it just made a lot of sense to have that cab that's lockable, therefore we can leave our stuff in there. So also when you're running like this, you'd be surprised at how quiet it makes it once you lock everything down and you're coming home. It's phenomenal. Moving inside the cab, behind the seats here, we've got a phenomenal amount of room here for storage and things like that. I'm still working out how I'm setting this up, so we haven't really worked out how we're going to put stuff, but that's how we've got it set at this stage. Over on the driver's side, You've got all your access to your stereo, USB charger, and cigarette lighter. Your speakers are down in here behind the seats. I've also put the EPIRB and fire extinguisher right in the doors, so if something does go wrong, they're easy to access and get to. We've also made this seat, the passenger seat storage area, all the safety gear, so if you need to access any of the safety gear, all you have to do is just sort of walk in here. The other reason I've made it that is the BSM 3 is in under here, so by having nothing else in here, there's no chance of it getting knocked and bumping the electronics or damaging the electronics. Okay, moving forward into the cab now. So all your controls as the captain are really easy to access. Everything's right at your fingertips. The electronics on it, I've gone for Simrad this time. We've gone for a 16-inch touchscreen up the front there, and then the NS2009, sorry, as the standalone sounder. And I have to say, the electronics package has been phenomenal. So with the way they're marking fish is excellent compared to the other stuff that I had on the old boat. Once again, instrument panel down the front here, easy to access, easy to read. The finish that Sailfish do is excellent. The way they've boarded up again, you know, the wiring is phenomenal, and I'll show you that in a sec. So, but yeah, everything's easy to get to. All the Garmin electronics is all hooked up to the engines, so the engine telemetry and everything else all runs through Garmin, and the menu system on the Garmin is really, really good actually. I was really surprised with it. I was a bit skeptical on the Garmin stuff to start with, but what it allows you to do is, you know, you can set everything, you can see your fuel flow rates, fuel left in the tanks, you know, you name it, you can pretty much set it on those Garmins, so really happy with those. Something else that Sailfish don't normally do is 27 meg. I put the 27 meg in just for the style of fishing that we do. We've also got the VHF in there, and I went white just for a bit of contrast in the black cab, so something a bit different there. Also comes standard with a sunroof. If I had my time again already, I would put a second sunroof in the passenger side, just to allow a bit more airflow through the cabin. The windows open up as they are now, but I've found already with summer it gets quite warm in here if you're not moving, if you're sitting here burling or doing something like that. So having a second rooftop hatch would allow just to ventilate the cab a little bit better. Moving down into the cab itself now. So I went for the rod storage in the bunks or above the bunks, just so when we're fishing, like I said, we travel down of a night, a Friday night after work, and like to be able to sleep in here and lock everything up, so we can lock all our rods and reels and everything in here. The cabin windows, the port windows, they open up, and they've got fly screens in them, and they are excellent. I've also added the 12-volt fans up the front there on either side, just so when it does get a bit warm in here of a night, you can turn the fan on, you've got a nice breeze running over you. The other thing that we added in here was the inverter, so we can charge all our electronics, also vacuum sealing fish and all that sort of stuff. We can run all that there with no issue whatsoever. This turns into a massive bunk, so we've got infills that go all in through here and fill this up, and it's, you know, it is a massive bunk for two of us, it's and the dog. It's been phenomenal. I'll just give you a look here at the electronics. So this is, you know, the way Sailfish finish off their electronics is phenomenal. So really neat. Comes with a diagram, all that sort of stuff, and the finish on it, like I said, you cannot fault their electronics finish whatsoever. So that's pretty much the Sailfish, guys. Like I said, we've done 27 hours on the boat now, haven't had an issue, everything's working really well. Highly recommend a Sailfish to anyone. And yeah, if anyone wants any more info, please drop us an email, get in touch with us. More than happy to talk about the boat.